Bobby, opening thoughts, how would you assess a very well earned victory, I guess, hard fought?
Yeah, we had some, we had the issues with foul trouble. We had key guys had to really sit for long stretches in that first half, so we just had to fight through, battle through that. I thought our defense really kept us in it, and we contested them pretty well early in the game. They scored too many points in the paint. We tried to fix that, which we got better as the game progressed. The guy stepped up. I know Remy was tremendous. Shot making, and big plays down the stretch. But overall, it was a connected group. It was a team that was motivated to win in one of the toughest places you could play in college basketball, and just really proud of the effort tonight.
You went up 8. They go on a 10-1 run, but then you guys immediately respond. How critical was it at that juncture to kind of regain control of the game?
Yeah, I mean, we knew that they're going to make a push, and they have the crowd behind them, and it was senior day for them. So there was, and they've been playing pretty good. If you take out the Oregon game, which Oregon was playing pretty well at the time as well. So they're, it was a great win. I felt a key part, in terms of was Brandon Williams and Coleman being out of the game, late in the game. It just made it a little bit easier for us to guard them. They didn't quite have, the creators that they would have if either of those guys were on the floor.
In your opinion, what does this do for your NCAA tournament resume, Bob?
I mean, I'm just going to Vegas with these guys, feel great about that, and push to try and compete for a championship. And, I know that we've done enough, and I knew coming in if we got this one that there would be no doubt. So I really feel strongly that we have a great record in conference, in a power conference. We're number 2, in sole possession of that. And we have the wins that, the 3 wins in the non-conference that we can't take away from us. So it's, and we don't have a bad record. There's a lot of teams with bad records. We have a good record. We've had quality wins, and we have 12 wins in our conference. So you can't really ask more.
In the first half,
how important was the way Remy played, given Rob's offensive struggles, foul trouble, et cetera?
Yeah, I mean, that's an underrated thing, about the team in this game was, Rob didn't have his best stuff at all on offense, and we still, managed to find a way to get a win. And I think, obviously Remy was a big part of that. That's a big thing, because I felt like if Rob doesn't give us, 14, 16, 18, that we've struggled offensively, and we found different ways to put enough points on the board.
In the first half, Valtonen gave you a lot of quality minutes. Can you talk about the coverage?
Yeah, I mean, every minute matters, and he came in, Elias, and played, probably 6 to 8 minutes. I don't know what his minute total was, and he moved his feet well on defense. He had one drive that he had the charge late in the half, but he didn't hurt us. Actually, I think we closed the gap some when he was in the game, so he had some really good minutes.
It's your first year, your first win in this arena as a coach or a player. Do you feel like you kind of got lucky off your back in that regard?
I mean, I never go into the game thinking my life won't be complete if I don't, win here. We just went to war. I mean, these games are what you live for, to be able to coach in this type of environment with that fan base, and our crowd was equal to this, in our first matchup. And that's why college basketball is great. You get these rivalries, and you get the type of energy in the building, and you got to overcome all that. It's pretty special when you can accomplish that.
What about those fans that made the trip to this game? Were you able to hear that?
I did at the end of the game when things got a little out there, but we appreciate the support and our people just getting behind our season the way they have. Really, the last 2 years it's been unbelievable.
Bobby, Remy was hurt to start the season, and then he kind of had to change his game a little bit for you guys to play at your best. Just can you sum up how well he has played during the conference portion of the season?
Yeah, I mean, he, like you said, he wasn't himself, and you've seen over conference play a healthy, energetic. I think you need players like him. Cheatham's a winner. Remy Martin's a winner. When the game's on the line, he finds a way to make big shots and defends. And he's mixing his game up well. He's finding his teammates. He's playing at an elite level, all conference level.
When Remy plays, I mean, he takes some shots, you think, oh, no, unconventional. Does he require more patience on your part?
He started, the only thing I was a little upset about with Remy tonight was he had a bad turnover when we were going through a turnover stretch, and we didn't need that, and it was a careless one. Other than that, I didn't really have an issue with anything that Remy did tonight.
How problematic was Dort getting three, especially when you don't have Cherry?
No, you're rolling the dice a little bit, but in this environment, you know, I felt I had to get Remy off the floor, you know, because he had played the whole half, and that was really the only reason that we went back in, and I needed to give Remy a breather, and he got himself into a bad spot, but, you know, that's a feel thing for me, putting guys in with two fouls. It's not like a hard, fast rule about how I do that. I just kind of see if I can manage it.
Did you second guess yourself?
Well, I mean, any time that it goes from two to three, then you say, like, why did I do that?
But, I mean, even in the second half, you had Remy out just for, I mean, maybe a minute, and they go on 5 rounds.
I mean, again, I have to try and to close the game and to, because we might have had a 5, 6, 8-point lead. I mean, in my heart, in my mind, I was saying, like, you know, this thing's going to be like a one-possession game by when it's all said and done. So needed to get him off the floor just to give him a chance to close the game. So when that little thing happened, that 5-0, I mean, it was like the first thing I did was point to him to get back in the game.
After their guards fouled out, you guys really turned it up defensively. Was there anything said, or was that just them taking the initiative?
If you watch all the great wins that we've had this year, there's been a high-level finishing component to our defense late in games, and you know, moving our feet, making teams shoot tough shots, and then rebounding. We did it against Washington, we did it against Oregon, you know, we did it in overtime versus Arizona first time. So you know, that's who they are. I mean, when we are that team and we do that, then we're tough to beat.
Bobby, you know what college basketball rivalries are like. And this one's been so one-sided for so long. What does sweeping Arizona this year, in your fourth year, does that make any sort of statement as far as what you're building here at ASU?
I just have so much appreciation for the success and the tradition that Arizona has. So anytime you're able to win two games in a season versus them, then you're doing something right. And you know, I know that they lost a lot, but they're still well coached, and those guys compete, and they played hard. And you know, I take a lot of pride in the fact that our team stepped up. It meant a lot to the guys in the locker room to want to you know, win this game and finish our regular season the right way.
Does this environment rival the team that you went through during your playing days in the ACC?
It's tough to say. I mean, our place was louder than this, but really, I'm not sure that there's been a louder arena than this place, other than a few select times, you know, our Kansas game, and there's, you know, that at times, at moments, matched this crowd. It's I mean, it's always hard to gauge. You know, Kansas again was pretty loud there. Kentucky, I've been there, so I've been a lot of places. So it's in the top 5 to 10, I guess.
Coach, I got one more.
Because I am, like, every second I stand here, I say something less intelligent. So, you know, just from, you can just keep.
Coach, Kamani, at this sometimes a struggle offensively this year. What did it mean for him to make some big shots today and just play big minutes for you guys today?
Yeah, I mean, we needed him, especially with Tayshaun being out and losing those minutes and that production. And he's practiced well. And, you know, he played well in our last game versus Oregon State. It didn't reflect that in the box score or point total, but his defense and rebounding and then his free throws, made some clutch free throws, and you just played a really, really good all-around game again.
Thanks, coach.
Thank you, guys.
Appreciate it.